opinions and stories around the game we love, told by your favorite storytellers. Stay up to date with all things cricket. Subscribe to Cricbuzz's YouTube channel and press that bell icon now.
So here, if you have to look back at the Indian batting, obviously disappointing, but they probably want to dig a little deeper into that rather than just saying it was disappointing, wouldn't they?
Yes, absolutely. Like I mentioned earlier, it has to be around partnerships. When you're looking at chasing around 250, you just need two good partnerships, and they fail to do that. So that is something which you have to just regroup, talk about it, have little conversations around that. It's just about sticking to basics. You know, when you're approaching batting as a group, it's important that you focus on those partnerships. When you lose wicket, it's about building that first 10-15 run partnership and then taking the game on from there. Those small little things will be discussed, I suppose. But it's all about getting the good start. I'm a big believer in that. Be it with the ball or with the bat, you got to start the inning. You got to set the tone nicely, and then things just kind of fall into place for you. So that is the basics of the game, which you have to just constantly keep on reminding yourselves every time you go out there on the field.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, you mentioned it briefly, Michael, on Cricbuzz Combox, that sometimes when you have a clump of wickets, there will be the odd soft dismissal, Shikhar Dhawan down the leg side, Rishabh Pant's full toss, just bunted to mid-on, as it were. But really, apart from a couple of those, there were maybe the odd shot, like, for example, Hardik Pandya, which could have been ill-timed, shall we say.
Yeah, I mean... Hardik obviously wanted to target the off spinner. It's spinning in. He feels he can hit the ball over the rope, but not too sure he needed to take such a high risk option on it at that stage, with Jadeja and himself playing nicely. It's just one of those innings for India where you could sense, and I'm with Zat, that the tone didn't quite get set. I know Rohit went quite cheap, but the first two or three overs, I thought they were almost waiting for the bad ball. You know, I think in this era, even though the ball might be doing something, you've got to really show intent to say to the bowler, right, we're looking to hit you. You know, it was the body language of the opening pair that I watched. I was like, you know, it didn't feel like they were, you know, really aggressive in their mindset. When you start like that and you start a little bit timidly, a little bit of the rub of the green goes against you, one down the leg side. I thought Suri Kumar Yadav was unlucky with that ball that triggers back onto the stumps. Sam, when Virat played that, it was just a little push through extra cover off top there. I went, oh, here we go. Here we go. Virat's back. He's going to play one of those innings. But, you know, Virat's shot was a poor one. It didn't look like they had the intensity today, India, with the bat in hand.
Yeah, intensity could be one way to describe it, Zaheer, because, you know, when we talk about that, I mean, fans obviously have a lot of expectation, but on the Cricbuzz app, for a few minutes when I was not watching the game, I was following it there. And Virat starts with a boundary, then another, then a third. And already people started saying, here comes number 71. I mean, I know fans is not everything to go by, but there almost seemed to be that, okay, you're sort of taking certain things for granted.
Well, when you talk about Virat and the kind of things which he has achieved in his career, you know, those expectations he carries every time he walks into bat. And he did look good today. He started well. He hit a couple of really good shots, one through the covers as well, which was stopped. He looked that you know, something big is happening or a good innings is coming. But when you know you're going through this sort of a patch, you kind of get out at times, and that's what happened. So yes, you can look at it, bowlers getting on top of you, or you can look at it, people analyzing you, but these things are going to be there, and you know, with every innings, till the time you don't get that big one, these kind of talks will continue, and I'm sure it's just part and parcel of the game. So Virat has been around long enough to know what to expect, how to manage these things. And as a cricketer, like we all always say, you know, you just have to believe that the next time you're going to be walking in, you've got to believe that it's your day.
Is there, I mean, just to finish off on this and not to labor too much on it, Michael, I throw my mind back to Sachin Tendulkar in 2003, and I know it's been oft quoted when he had certain problems and he cut out a particular shot that was getting him out often. And he said, I'm not going to play that shot. Sydney Test match, fourth test, 2003, 2004. And he ends up getting a double hundred without one particular shot in the book. Is there something almost similar that a great player like Virat Kohli can do to tell himself that if there is a repeat dismissal, if I'm getting out too often, just outside off, hanging my bat out to dry, can I fix it?
Yeah, I mean, in one-day cricket, it's harder to do that because you've got to get on with it and you've got to keep the scoreboard ticking. I guess in test match cricket, you can. You have the time and the kind of way to just say, okay, for a session or two, I'm not going to play that shot that's been getting me out. But in one-day cricket, no, I mean, I watched Virat and I've watched him closely here, and every time he bats, I think he looks fine. And then he's out. He just surprises you when he gets out. It's not something that I see in his movement or his technique that is clearly a flaw. He's just making the odd mistake, probably concentration. It's his mind. I've said it for weeks and weeks. He needs a breather from the game. He just needs a break from the game, get away from cricket, and then come back in a month or two's time, completely refreshed, completely recharged. And I reckon things might look a little bit easier for him. But at the minute, it just looks to me like it's that concentration, that mental toughness about watching the ball and reacting. It's very, very difficult if you're drained and you've been on this kind of conveyor belt for so long. You know, he just needs a little bit of a breather. And I'm sure once that happens, it'll just be that bit sharper in his mind, that bit sharper in concentration. And I think that's all it is. It's just the sharpness of his concentration that just seems to be lapsing at the minute.